What's going on, everyone? We're here with Stuart. We have a leg workout. Now, first off, to build your legs, it's all about mentality. You got to work. You got to push yourself. It's not just about going through there. I can give you a workout, or someone else can give you a workout program, but if you don't sit there and push yourself to your limits, then you're not going to grow. This workout is a bunch of volume. We start off, as you'll see, we start off with some heavy squats. So we did
two warm-up sets?
Yeah. Yeah, we did two warm-up sets, just not to failure or anything, maybe 10 reps. And then we moved on to heavier sets. We did, six sets of eight reps? Yeah, we did six sets of eight reps. I stuck around, I'm not sure, what was the weight, like
325.
Yeah, 325. We were using the Buffalo bar. This is a little bit different bar. It's for mainly what big guys, really.
Yeah, it's like keeps pressure off your shoulders.
Yeah, keeps pressure off your shoulders so that bigger guys, you know, have a problem with their arms and stuff grabbing on the bar.
Yeah, I need it.
Yeah, Stuart needs it. I don't really need it. So we use that bar just to kind of switch it up, and it's a heavier bar, so it's not like just a regular 45-pound bar. It is, what, they said 55?
Yeah.
I'm telling you, it seems heavier than a 55-pound bar. So we did those six sets, and by this time we're already spent. I'm telling you, those squats are really hard. If you push yourself and use the weight you should be using, you're going to be dead. If you get done with six sets of eight reps and you're fine, then you did not push yourself the way you should.
Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Push. Come on, push. Come on. Come on.
So after that, we moved on to, dumbbell squat. As you will see, we're actually got our heels on two 10-pound plates. Stuart's never done this before. I've done it in the past, and they work really well. It feels like a front squat, but for me, front squats always hurt my shoulders just because the weight or something. I'm not doing them right. I'm not really sure, but they always kill my shoulders. So dumbbell squats is a great alternative for that, and you can really feel it on the front of your quads a whole lot. And we did, six sets of 12 reps. Yeah. And this one, we're really trying to focus on going down in a negative really slow. And with the plates elevating your heels up, you're able to actually squat lower. You'll see us squatting pretty, it's really low.
Dumbbells touching the floor.
Yeah, pretty much. So it was a really low squat, and we, like I said, really focused on a real great negative and then going up pretty quick. So going down negative and then shooting back up. We did six sets of 12 reps.
Come on.
Come on, come on.
What was the lunges? We moved on to this one. We were going to use a bar, but
so
we decided with how our legs were feeling that it would be better to actually use a Smith machine. So we're doing a Smith machine reverse lunge with a half rep at the bottom, and that's where the hard part was doing that half rep. We weren't using that much weight at all. I was using, 35 on each end, and we did three sets of 10 reps, but with that half rep at the bottom, it really felt like 20 reps on each leg. So you would do all 10 reps on, let's say, the left leg, then you go immediately into the right leg. And golly, it was a burn. It was a killer doing that. The rest of the time, we used the belt the whole time, the weight belt. But this particular exercise, we did not because, I mean, we weren't using that heavy of weight. And then at the same time, it was hard to breathe after all that. Even with the dumbbell squats that we did, it was really hard to breathe. And that's another reason why it's so hard, it seems like, because you can't breathe so much because your knees are going into your chest pretty much.
Come on.
Ah! And after that, we moved on to more of an isolation. We moved on to the lying leg curls. This one was a killer for sure for the hamstrings. It was six sets of six reps being elevated. So you actually have your elbows on the pad, so your back is straight up. We did six sets, and then right after the six sets, you drop down and you're actually hugging the pad and you do 10 reps. Then after the 10 reps, you did 10 partials right after that. So it was back to back. So pretty much it was a drop set. So we did six reps immediately into 10 reps and then 10 partials. And we did that for six sets. And oh my gosh, it was a killer. Those I think the first two sets, my hamstrings honestly felt like they're gonna rip. So you have to really be careful with doing those, because if you're, it's one way to push yourself, but, and if you push too hard, you can actually rip something. So be careful when you do this, honestly, because it hurts so bad.
It's bad you have to say that on film.
Yeah,
right?
Be careful. Be careful when you do this, but no joke. I've done this maybe, this particular exercise, and then the next day I went and did some sprints, and honestly, I messed up my hamstring doing that because I was so sore because of this workout, because the hamstrings, I'm telling you, it's bad. Come on, push. Come on. Yeah, we went off on calves. We did some leg press, just calf raises, maybe like 5 or 6 sets.
Like 15.
Yeah, 5 or 6 sets of 15 reps, just going up, pausing for a second, and then going down in a negative to like a 3 count, and then right back up. And that was pretty much the whole workout. We killed it. It was a great workout. We did it under, I don't know, what, 2 hours?
Yeah, I mean, you should be failing your last sets anyways.
Yeah.
On every workout.
Yeah, and every single set we did, we're hitting failure. And then at the end of this, you're pretty much dying. If you can do more, then you're not, like I said, you're not pushing yourself, and that's how you're going to see results. If you're not pushing yourself, you're not going to see the results that you want. You can diet so hard, you can use supplements so much, but if you're not pushing yourself in the gym the way you should be, you're not going to see the results. So it's all about mentality. It's all about getting in the gym, killing it when you have the time, and you know, making the time in the gym really count. So you got anything else to say?
No, just keep working hard, guys.
All right, guys, that is it. We're out.